Hey, good evening. MonsterMTG here with my first YouTube video on this channel. I'm excited to be here, excited to bring you guys my first deck. It's a best of one on Simic colors. So what I wanted to showcase today was a Feasting Troll King deck we call Mill the Troll, right? The idea here is to get Feasting Troll King out as soon as possible. Typically, we can do it the old-fashioned way, right? Six mana drop, and then we get those three food tokens. But we want to get him out a lot faster than that, so we can just beat down our opponent before he knows what's happening. In order to do that, we're just going to put him in our graveyard, right? Because if we have three food tokens up, we can sack those, get him right there. So how are we going to do that, right? So ideally, what we want to do is just mill ourselves, right? So we do that with the aid of Tamiyo, right? If we can get her out, choose a card other than Feasting Troll King, right? So we want that in the graveyard. And typically what we're going to choose is something like Witch's Oven, right? Because we can get that out, we can sack a creature with four toughness or greater and create two tokens instead. That's really, really important, especially with Vantress Gargoyle, right? What this flyer does is, you know, it helps us give the opponent a little pressure if he has a lot of cards in his graveyard, or it allows a blocker for us in the early game when we have more cards, four more cards. But more importantly, it puts the top card of each player's deck into their graveyard, and we may get lucky and we may get a Feasting Troll King that way. But if we already have a Feasting Troll King out as a two drop, and if we have Witch's Oven out, right, we can sack this creature, get two food tokens. Say we have Gilded Goose or Oko, right? We generate another food token, and bam, we get Feasting Troll King out in second or third turn, if we're lucky. Other than that, we have Merfolk Secretkeeper as well to add for that milling of ourselves, or just a cheap blocker that really helps. Gilded Goose for the food tokens, possibly a blocker, or that mana if we need to get Oko or something similar out. Cauldron Familiar as well, gain life, opponent loses life. You guys have seen this a million times, you know what it is. That's basically it. You know, standard lands with three Fabled Passages to thin out that mana if needed to be. So I hope you guys enjoyed the deck. I had a lot of fun playing it. I'm going to showcase about four of those games today. Won some, I lost some. I've streamed for about 2 hours or so. I think the hardest part for me was up against aggro decks, or any decks where I needed some creature removal, some planeswalker removal, you know, sweepers and things like that. Because if you notice here, there's none of that. So this is an early game win deck. If you go into the late game with this, you're going to struggle pretty hard. But let me know what you guys think in the video. Leave comments down below. You know, tell me what I did good with, tell me what I did bad with. I know kind of screwed up a little bit here and there, but I'm still learning this deck. Hit that like button, and I'm going to be uploading each and every day from now on, as well as streaming over on Mixer. So check me out over there, MonsterMTG. Thanks, guys. Enjoy the video. Peace. So we're gonna actually wait, since we have three food tokens, just to see what we get. Let's get this out. Oh, I can't. That's right. Well, I guess I can, so I'll just do this. Yeah, we still can. We're still good. Still didn't get it. Alright, so yeah, we want to do that. Fortunately, can't really do anything else. We'll pass turn. This should do it though. This should get it out next turn pretty easily. we got? Oh, okay. Okay. Fair enough. Later, kitty. Shit, that will definitely work. Oops. Which is a oh boy. We got it, boys. We got it. This does 3 damage, right? Okay, so we'll just. Can we? Tempted to take this Fae of Wishes. What's he doing? All right, there we go. All right, so we will. Yeah, gosh dang it. Get away. I mean, he's gonna block. It doesn't matter, but he's gonna block. Obviously. He's looking at the witches. I'm like, what do I do with this? Oh, it's funny. I don't know what this guy's doing. Taking a sweet old time. I mean, yeah. Okay. He's looking at his cards. I can see him looking at his cards, but he will not play anything. I mean, he has one more spell he can play, I believe. Yeah. Okay, I think he was trying to figure out what to do. Because he can't play anything else. Oh, that's dangerous, though. That is dangerous. I mean, I can take out Saheeli and Narset with these two. And then when he does bring in Sarkhan, it won't really matter. But at the same time, I could just hit him for 8. Right? It makes sense to me. hit him. For 10. It's just way better. All right, let's see if I can get another troll out here. Wait, what do I got in here first? Shit. I don't really want. So let's do this. Let's do Cauldron Familiar, I guess. Doesn't really matter. Okay, I didn't get it, unfortunately. I'll play this. So, what is this? I mean, he could attack for 6, 8, right? So these two will turn. I think going face with him and then just go ahead and take it out. Narset would probably be the best thing to do right now. So at the most I'll take when he brings out Sarkhan is 4. And then with Feasting King, Trample. So he can only play two spells at a time. So he'll get one token. So he may be looking for a board wipe. He might be really looking for a board wipe. Yeah, he is. Alright, so everything's going to get wiped out. So that's it. That's all he can play. So hopefully he gets this ball going so I can, you know, freaking go. Let's go, bro. Let's go. Alright, so now we'll get Troll King back out. It's just never ending, bro. It's just never ending. Oh man, that's just funny. What do we got here? So I could just bring back. Gilded Goose. Just something to keep getting me tokens for right now. Could do this as well. I mean, this is a given. Then we'll go ahead and so this will get us a token and a blocker. So he's really saying here go, and I'm sitting here going.
I don't know. I think he's trolling me right now. He does not seem happy. Okay, token. Perfect. I don't need to really worry about that right now. So we'll just go ahead and in turn. Is he getting another wipe, really? So I think this is his, what, one third fate wishes. Okay, so it's three. Does he have another board wipe? So typically, from what I've seen, what I've done, I've only had one Kai's Wrath in any wish deck, Fires of Invention deck. But he, I don't know, we'll see what he has. Wow. That is not what I expected. And it took him a long, long time to... How is this only a 3-drop? Why could I not sacrifice that? What was he? I have no idea. Didn't really need that. Okay, let's see, what can I do here? Definitely swinging in for 5. Go ahead and just make this a 3/3. Because why not? Can't even find her. I'm sitting there wondering though, like, any scoops. Like, I think he did not realize that. Or maybe just forgot about Oko. I don't know. Oh yeah, I'm definitely keeping this. Yeah. It's gonna burn this. Need a blue land out first. Oh, there she is.
unfortunately, he just had too many lands, like with Risen Reef and 5 million Leaf King Druids. It's ridiculous. Let's just block that. So at the very least, the next turn I can get out Feasting Troll King, finally. That would have been nice to have, but one Tamiyo in a graveyard, so. Jesus. All them lands. He wants to take all my shit, apparently. Come on, buddy. There we go. Block. Blind to your folly. I have one in here, right? I do. Okay, so. Hopefully he doesn't get mass manipulation. Oh. Another druid. This just gets out of control. Man, I should just start milling him. He hadn't played a land yet. It's like ridiculous. He has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 lands out. And I have 5. It's like, what? Oh, boy. So I don't know why he didn't play that first, but It's all good, I guess. He's going to end up milling himself. he won't. Like, he probably is a mass manipulation by this point. Well, what should I do? Power three or less. Probably. God, I don't want to kill him though. We'll try it. We'll see what happens. Choose target. Yep. I mean, I'll get him back in a second, so it doesn't really matter. Guess he's not going to block. All right. It is. I imagine he has a mass manipulation though. And the problem with this deck, like if you try to play this at with paper and paper, like it would take so long to finish a game because of all the draws and the shuffles. It's just not feasible. At least at my LGS. I mean, when you have like 50 minutes to finish best of three, something like this would take a long, long, long time. It just takes too long. But yeah, we'll just concede. I mean, he has mass manipulation. He kind of got lucky in the beginning where he got all the Risen Reefs right away. Like he had two in like the first, I think his opening hand. So it's unlucky for us. This is not what I want.
this might be difficult. If I don't have any blockers. And he is Calvary. I don't know why this costs 2 freaking mana. That's kind of insane. Honestly, a little surprised people are still playing mono red. Because of all the board wipes, life gains, like Oko, with their much bigger creatures. There's two of them, of course he does. Man, this is his game. That is just insane. Like, I'm down 10 health because of 2 Cavalcades of Calamity. Do I want that right now? Probably should just go ahead and do this. I'm gonna need a blocker. This guy had every card he needed, didn't he? That is unbelievable. Another aggro deck. What do you know? He's thinking hard about what to do now. Really? Oh man, this game is fucking horrible.
Actually, I can't do that. Actually, what I should do. What's that? I can just play this. I'm good. Can't attack. I'll die. I can't get nine. If I survive this, I can get nine life. Why would you do that? Why would you do that? How did I end up with one health? I get more health with this, but I probably should. Oh, he's the scooper. Got him. Guy. If anybody else has noticed that, I have. I just think it's probably the weirdest thing I've ever seen. Like, I've played more red aggro decks than anything else. Okay. we get the big boy out. Now we get the big boy out. Oh boy. Here we go, boys. Here we go. Let's go. Man, we're getting everything out right now. Everything, boys. Everything. All right. Should be fine. Yeah. In turn. God, Jesus. That's ridiculous, by the way. Swing it in, boys. We'll probably have to sack Vantress Gargoyle here pretty soon. Just so I can get food tokens. Survive. Yeah. Every time I play a mono red deck, Cavalier Calamity 2. Dude, it's only used in this opening hand. It's like, come on, man. Oh, it's ridiculous, by the way. Get them, boys. So, I don't know. Hopefully, he just got a land. Thank God. So, I don't know if I can survive this. I can get 6 health. Yeah, let's do that.
Got him. Yeah, motherfuckers. Good games. Good games all around. It was good to beat Mono Red. That was a tough one. That was a tough one. Yeah. Well, that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this deck. I had a lot of fun playing it. I had a lot of good games, a lot of close games that I won. And then a lot of games where I just got stomped. You know, Mono Red is really strong against this. I did beat it. But, you know, that was just kind of a one in a million, but it's not very common, you know. But I had a lot of fun. Hopefully you guys too did enjoy it. Hopefully you guys make it and build it yourselves and see how well you can pilot it. But other than that, thanks guys. Later.